Wondering why your hair is shedding? Well, I have some interesting answers for you. If you're new to my channel and if you're not, welcome back. I'm Mike. I'm a hairdresser, a L'Oreal colour specialist, a makeup fan and a skincare lover. In today's film, we're going to be talking about hair shedding and hair cycle. What causes hair shedding? When you should worry about hair shedding? And why does hair actually shed? So if you want to find out more about this very interesting topic, then you better keep on watching. What is this story, everyone? I'm your professor for today of Hairdressing Science 101. Today's film is all about hair shedding. What is hair shedding? When you should worry about hair shedding? What types of hair shedding are they? And what is a hair growth cycle? Because no one really knows what a hair growth cycle is. So let's get into it. How many of you wash your hair and you look in the bath and there is loads of hair and you're like, oh goodness God, am I going bald? What is going on with my hair? Well, let me start by saying that everyone loses 60 to 100 hair a day. So I wouldn't really worry about it. Hair sheds and it's very natural. So finding hair on your hairbrush or in the bath, it's very normal. But why do we see it on our bath, especially when it comes to women? They'll be saying to me, they're like, oh well, it doesn't happen to my husband, doesn't happen to my sister, such as such. First of all, let me put it this way. When your hair is a lot longer, and especially when it's dark, it's easier to see hair. When you've hair like my length, when it sheds, you're probably not gonna see it in the bath because it's just all gonna go down the drain. When your hair is a lot longer and you've a lot thicker hair, obviously it's going to clog up and stick to your bat, and you're going to be able to see it on the pillow, especially with darker hair. So that's why probably blondes don't see it as much. When should you start worrying about shedding? If it's just normal shedding and you just find hair on the brush or in the bat, everything is okay. You're not in trouble. You should really worry when you start seeing bald patches on your head or if your hair is coming out in clumps. And when I say bald patches, I mean actual bald patches. I don't mean like, oh, I've receding hairline, there's something wrong. We all have a receding hairline. There is actually few types of shedding, so let me talk about each and one. First of all, we have natural shedding. So that's the shedding we spoke about. Shedding that happens due to hair cycle. And we're actually gonna talk about hair cycle and why natural shedding happens later on in the film, so keep on watching. Then we have excessive shedding, clinically known as telogen effluvium, if I pronounce this correctly. So this shedding is a lot more advanced and it usually happens due to shock or stress, and it also happens postnatally to women that have been pregnant. So it is quite common in women that had babies and you're after losing most of your hairline and you see baby hair growing. And like that, if this happens to you due to stress or shock, please seek the help of trichologists. I'm a hairdresser and I can only give you the information that I know. So let's get into hair cycle. What is hair cycle? Hair cycle is the hair growth cycle of hair. Duh, obviously. So like that, hair, like your skin, sheds. So when you think of skin, the skin layer comes off and there's a new layer of skin growing on top of it. The same thing happens to your hair. But like that, a hair growth cycle has a lot to do with how long your hair is gonna grow, when your hair is shedding, how your hair is shedding, and everything that we're really talking about. So let's get deep inside. So hair growth cycles happens in three stages. We've anagen, catagen, and telogen. Anagen stage lasts anything from 3 to 5 years. So this is where your hair grows. 80% of your hair grows during this stage. Hair follicles are active and they're growing. The hair gets blood supply from the papilla and it just ends up growing. So the longer your anagen stage is, the longer your hair is gonna be. So in this stage, your hair really grows. Your hair will grow to a certain length and then it will start shedding because the lifespan of your hair is finished. Your hair is then dead and just comes out, and that's what you find on your pillow. So anagen stage is really the main stage. Anagen stage can last anywhere from 3 to 5 to even 7 years, really depending on your genetics and your own health. So the longer the stage is, the longer your hair is gonna be. Another thing is, all the hair grows at different speeds and all of your hair is in different stages, because let's say if all of your hair finished anagen stage, you'd literally lose all your hair and then you'd end up being bald and then all the hair would start growing again. So all the hair on your head is at different stages of growth. That's why we lose that amount of hair, because the hair that's coming out is probably 5 years old, if that makes sense. So once anagen stages, catagen stage comes into play. Catagen stage lasts anywhere from 3 to 4 weeks, and we lose only 1% of our hair during that time. During catagen stage, the hair follicle starts to shrink and detach itself from the derma papilla. The growth slows down during this stage. So this is the stage where your hair really goes up that hair shaft and is ready to come out. So once this stage is over, then we have the final stage, tenogen. Tenogen stage can last anywhere from 3 to 4 months. It's also known as resting or shedding phase. We lose about 60% of our hair during that stage, and this stage allows for the new hair growth to happen. So as we can see in my hair, right? I have all this fluffy new hair. This is brand new hair. So I did have hair here, then it all came out during tenogen stage, and then thanks to tenogen stage, the hair had a chance to grow again. This can sound very, very confusing. So let's recap everything. With three hair stages, you've the first stage which your hair grows, the second stage when the hair starts to rest and the follicle starts to shrink, and the third stage where your hair sheds and it starts to come out and allows the new hair to grow. So basically, shedding is natural. It happens to everyone. I wouldn't really worry about it, and it's something that happens to everyone. You're probably worrying about it because some of your hair may just shed more at once. Let's put it this way. I've often seen clients coming in, they're like, oh, my hair is shedding a lot, and I've never seen that before. Probably because most of your hair is in tenogen stage at that stage, and it's starting to come out. And that's just normal. And like I said, unless you see bald patches or it's literally coming out in clumps, so if you're gonna reef your hair and everything comes out in your hands, that's when you should start worrying. But other than that, stages of hair growth is something very natural, and it's gonna determine the length of your hair and the lifespan of your hair and how much you're gonna shed. And remember, if you've dark, thick hair, you're more than likely gonna see more hair on your pillow than someone that has fine blonde hair or short brown hair like me. So you guys, thank you for watching today's film. I hope you enjoyed this little hairdressing science lesson. I hope you found this film rather interesting, helpful and useful. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel. Also check out my other social media. And of course you guys, please take care. Bye.